Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So today's video I'm very excited about. So excited, my lips are tingling, but that could just be because of the lip gloss. Anyways, today's video is the second part to the Best of Beauty, where I said I really couldn't decide on a few lip products, so I was gonna have to dedicate a full video to my lip products because I didn't want to make that Best of Beauty video like 20 minutes long. It was already a long video, but like I said, I don't like to give you guys like super long videos. Let me know in the comment section how you guys feel. Should I try to keep them shorter or longer? That's actually a question I should have brought to you guys a while ago, because I know I talk a lot, guys. For those of you guys who are new to my channel, hi, my name is Mariaagloriaa, welcome. I talk a lot. Just an FYI, so if you guys like a lot of talking in videos, what's good? If you guys don't...
Pippity poppy, give me the zobbity.
Yes, sir.
I'll catch you on the flippity flip. But I have compiled my products, all of my favorite products of the year, my favorite lip liners, my favorite lipsticks, and my favorite lip glosses. So let's just go ahead and get right into this. We're gonna start off with my favorite lip liners of the year. I actually had to drive out and pick up my favorite lip liner of the year. And I don't know if you guys have actually, like, seen me use it, but this is literally the lip liner that I finished earlier this year, and then I had to repurchase, and then I lost the one I repurchased, and then I just never bought it again because I just wanted to try something else. But nothing has quite compared to this one. I literally just bought it. I ran to Target this morning. I went and got it,
and I hope someone walks up soon so I can say welcome to Target. I just want to say welcome to Target.
And it was the last one, because I honestly was gonna buy two, and then I saw that there was only one, and I was like, fam, why? So this is the lip contour liner in Soft Nude. This is my absolute favorite lip liner, guys, ever, and here is why. It is my perfect nude. The only thing about it that I don't love, that I wish was a little bit different, is I wish it wasn't a mechanical pencil. Making it a mechanical pencil gives it a shorter lifespan than a pencil you could sharpen. The wood in lip liner pencils helps keep the actual liner moisturized and helps it from drying out. It's just different with plastic mechanical ones, but this is the most perfect nude, guys. I'm telling you, like, there's not a nude out there like this. If you guys are my skin tone or similar, there's just, it's a beautiful nude. It's a brown, soft nude. It's not a red brown nude. It's not a peach brown nude. It's not a brown brown nude. It's the most perfect nude, and that is why I love it. There's nothing that I have found that quite compares to this. I would say second favorite, because look at it. This is from Milani. This is my Milani permanent lip liner in the shade 04 All Natural. You guys, this, you guys can see how this one is a little bit more rose and mauve than this one. Like, this one's nude nude. This one's like a rose pinky mauve nude, but I love this lip liner so much. This is actually the lip liner that I'm wearing right now. Love this lip liner. It is so flattering on so many people. It's from Milani. It's a pencil lip liner, so it stays really creamy. It stays really, like, soft and luxurious feeling. It just glides right on. And the thing I also really, 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 really love about it is the fact that these lip liners come with the option of, like, you can sharpen them, which the plastic ones don't, which is unfortunate. I love being able to sharpen it, and I actually, when I have a lot of time, I sometimes reach for this way more than I reach for this. This is an amazing lip liner. It's one of my all-time favorites. For those of you guys who have asked if I overline my lips, I do overline my lips. I overline one side of my lip. I've mentioned this before, and if you guys caught me on my live earlier, you guys remember this shirt, and you'll remember this conversation, hopefully. So this side of my lip really rounds out, and this one goes straight down. So I really have to, like, manipulate and kind of round this side of my lip out just to match this side. So I do overline this side of my lip and just this part. Everywhere else is pretty normal. Everywhere else is my lip shape 1000%. Finding the right lip liner for that honestly helps so much. I also do like using lip liners because I do like the contrast between, like, your lip color and your foundation. I don't like my lips to just melt into my face. I like that definition of, like, my lips popping out and giving my lip color some attention, because I like my lip color and I want it to stand out. Even though it's mostly nudes that I wear, I still like my lips to stand out. So that's why I really like lip liners. My last lip liner that you guys knew I was gonna mention, actually this isn't my last, I have one more that I want to talk about. This is my Wet n Wild in Bare to Comment. I just talked about this lip liner and it's so good. It's such a beautiful, what I would call a peach nude, which I really like peach nudes. This is such an amazing formula. It's so creamy. It's so pretty. This lip liner actually got me the question of, have I gotten lip injections? Do I add filler to my lips? Absolutely not. I do overline this side of my lip. I think it's just the color that really gives my skin and my lips, like, a nice contrast. And I really like how this lip color complements. And it's Wet n Wild. This is by far the most affordable one of the bunch, I believe. I think I got this for 99 cents. crazy affordable, but super awesome. The last one I want to talk about is the Exaggerate Rimmel London Lip Liner. This one is in 032. Wait, this isn't the one I wanted to talk about. It's this one by Rimmel. This is the Lasting Finish Rimmel Lip Liner in Tiramisu. This is also one you can sharpen, which I love. And it is a gorgeous terracotta nude, which I really, 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 really like. It's kind of a little bit of red tinge to it. And I really like this lip liner. Again, it's super complimentary to my skin. Again, it's one of those that you can sharpen so you can get the point nice and precise. And I love the formula. I love the way it wears. I think Rimmel lip liners are so slept on. I love Rimmel lip liners. They make some of the best lip liners in the drugstore. I love them so very much. Give this one a shot if you're looking for a good nude and an affordable one. I think the Pixie is the most expensive one. I think the Pixie lip liners are $7 or $8. They might be more expensive, but I'm telling you, like, this color for me, at least personally, is so worth it. But yes, these are my favorite lip liners of 2018, and I cannot live without them. I honestly can't go without lining my lips. I line my lips all the time. So lipsticks and liquid lips. I only really want to talk about two liquid lips, and they're both from Pixie. No, this video is not sponsored. You guys know I'm very upfront when it comes about that type of ish. But the Pixie by Petra, what are they called? Matte Last Liquid Lipsticks. I have two to talk about. One is in Bare Beauty, which is this one. This one in Bare Beauty. Gorgeous. I love it. One of my favorite nudes. So obsessed with this color. So obsessed with this formula. This formula is uber comfortable. Super long wearing, but not sticky. For a drugstore brand, this is really high quality stuff, guys. And I know it's Target. I know Pixie's a little bit more expensive than most drugstore brands, but I think it's really worth it because you get a lot. The formula is bomb. The color selection and the tones are so spot on. The next one is in Matte Beige, another one of my all-time favorites. This one is definitely more mauve. I've worn both of these on camera. You guys saw me actually test these out. I really like the Matte Last Liquid Lips. I think they're bomb. Another lipstick I want to mention, and I don't want you guys to feel the need to run out and buy this because it's super bougie, it's super expensive. This was actually sent to me, but I honestly would feel like I'm lying to you guys or keeping a secret from you guys if I didn't talk to you about it, because I actually wear this lipstick all the time. It's one of my favorite lipsticks slash like color toppers. So this is YSL's shade 10. I think they're called the Rouge Perfection lipsticks. You guys, this is such a pretty lip color. It is the most perfect pinky nude. It's a cream finish, which I really, really, really like. You guys see that? Do you see how pretty and nude that is? This is exactly how I use this lipstick too, guys, by the way. I literally just put it in the center of my lips, and it just adds something to the lip color. It adds thing and it brings the look together. It's awesome. I know it's expensive, but if you guys are in the market for treating yourself to a YSL lipstick, but you're not sure of which one to invest your money in, because these are investments, bomb formula. They wear really comfortably. Let me tell you, you're not going to be spending your money on something that's gross or sticky or uncomfortable. These are very comfortable, but expensive. But if you're looking to invest, I'm going to tell you right now, they're not bad. You actually would be getting your money's worth. You get a lot of product too. I've had this for a minute, you guys. I've used this tons and I still got a good amount left. Two lipsticks I have to talk about because I love them and did show them so much love this year, and they really had my back this year. Both from MAC, both staples I think everybody should own. So this one is MAC's Honey Love. I mentioned this, you guys, perfect. Such a beautiful lip color. It's very similar to YSL's, only YSL is a very, and this one is a little bit more on the matte side. It's not necessarily a matte finish, but it's definitely not as creamy as the YSL one. And then Velvet Teddy, which is a tried and true, we all know it, we all love it. That is Velvet Teddy, perfect lip color. I've raved about Velvet Teddy so many times already. I don't want to go on about these too much again because they are very raved about here on YouTube. I had to mention them because they were definitely like my boys this year, and I love them. If you guys are going to invest in good nudes at MAC, even though they're not as expensive, but they can be a little up there in price, I think they're like $15 or $16. These are great options, guys. I love these, and I think that they are so flattering on so many people. If you guys are in the hunt for a good nude lipstick, these babies. I'm a slore for lip glosses. This is why I couldn't just pick one for my favorites. You guys know what I'm saying? And even though like some of the favorites I talked about, two products, I couldn't even choose two. So we're going to try to get through these as fast as possible. I'm going to mention the Urban Decay ones right off the bat because I think Urban Decay killed it with this formula. Urban Decay's Hi-Fi Shine Lip Glosses. So effing bomb. So brilliantly formulated. They are perfect shades, most perfect tones, most perfect nudes. I think they nailed the most perfect pink. So this is Obsessed, like bubblegum pink lip gloss. I'm telling you, it's gonna be so complimentary to a white smile. It's gonna make your teeth look whiter. And then Midnight Cowgirl, hello, perfect flippin' icy nude. This is stunning. Like, look how gorgeous that is. I love their finishes too. They have a cream finish, they have a glitter finish, and then they have like a metallic finish, which is this guy right here, which isn't really metallic, it's just very glittery. And I raved about this and raved about this and raved about this, guys. I know it's such an intimidating lip gloss because it literally looks like somebody just melted gold, but this is such a stunning, I wouldn't call it so much a lip gloss as much as a lip topper. The way I really like to wear this is popping on a nice lip liner, popping on a nice nude lipstick of your choice, popping this over, and it emphasizes your lips like you would not believe. Urban Decay killed it with this formula. Yes, these are expensive, but if you guys are in the market to treat yourself to really high-end quality, not saying that the drugstore doesn't have great lip gloss because they do, but if you guys want to treat yourself to a high-end brand lip gloss, Urban Decay definitely didn't come to play. Moving on to a lip gloss that was my obsession since the second I got it, you guys. Again, this is not sponsored. This is the Pixie Chloe Morello collaboration lip gloss in the shade Birthday Cake. I'm so full of swatches, but I'm just gonna try and make this one happen. Look how stunning this is. It literally, like, you know what this reminds me of? It reminds me of strawberry funfetti cake. Like, that's what I think about when I see this, when I put it on my lips. This is the most comfortable lip gloss. It's not sticky. It's not thick, uncomfortable at all. It's honestly the lightest formula I've ever tried in a lip gloss that still gives so much of a kick when it comes to pigment and when it comes to, like, gloss and overall, like, shine to your lips. It has little specks of glitter, which gives it so much definition. I don't know if it's, like, discontinued, but if you guys are in the market, like, if you guys want to splurge on a good lip gloss, Urban Decay's got you, but so does Pixie, because Pixie's lip icing lip glosses, the formula, I'm telling you guys, the formula itself is so worth it. It's just dope, fam. Like, it, baby girl, it got you like you would not believe. The last one I want to mention is actually when my friend Yolanda, or Yolis, as you guys might remember her here on my channel, she went through, I think, 3 bottles in the course of 2 months, which is a lot, guys. It's hard to review beauty products, guys, and get through anything because you're constantly reviewing something new. So you'll find something new and then you'll leave the one thing you're obsessed with. So you never actually finish anything when you're a makeup addict. It's the worst thing, but it is a thing. So for her to go through so many bottles of this lip gloss, like, that's saying something. That's definitely saying something. I'm still on my first, but you guys, this is the lip gloss that I'm wearing, and I was wearing nothing but lip liner under, and now I topped it off with that YSL lipstick. But this, so perfect because it's very plumping. If you guys are looking for a lip gloss that plumps because it gives you this tingly feeling, it's nothing painful, it's nothing too exaggerated, but it's perfect because it really does plump up your lips, which I already have big lips, but because I wear a lot of liquid lips, my lips do tend to dry up, and when your lips get dry, they definitely, like, shrink in a little bit. This kind of brings life to them, and I really, 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 really appreciate it for that. It's actually a very comfortable tingle. I don't mind it. I personally don't mind it, and it just gives you, like, the nice, juiciest, plumpest lips, and it's e.l.f., you guys. This is so affordable. I think this is, like, $6. So worth it, and you get so very, very much, and I love the packaging, and this color, ugh. But that is it, you guys. These are my favorite. As you guys can see, I stick with my nudes. I definitely stick with my nudes. These are my favorite lip products of the year. I do want to try and go a little darker next year, or this year technically, because we are in 2019 now as I film this. But I honestly am so happy that I found, like, such dope nudes. Like, nudes that I'll definitely carry with me forever. Like, these lip liners, telling you right now, these lip liners aren't going anywhere. But I love you guys so very much. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please leave down below what your favorite all-time lip product is, whether it be a lipstick, whether it be a lip liner. Please, I really want to know. I asked this question on Instagram. Whatever you want to leave down there, leave down there. I love you guys so much though, and I will catch you in my next video.